has gone along the way. Lifting our hands to you. Here we are, giving you thanks for all you do. And as we praise, worship your holy name. Dwelling within our brain. Days we cannot see,
for days we cannot see,
for all that's yet to be,
so much is yet to be.
Trials we may have to face, when we believe on your grace, it will be a strength that saves us. Your love has made us strong. Through it all, we'll sing this song.
Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise to Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Brothers and sisters, for God to dwell in us, we must first empty ourselves from all our sins so that God can fill us up and can dwell within us. After all, the closest we can be to God is when we repent, because repentance is going back, union, united back again with God. The prodigal son's story tells it all. His repentance united him back to his father. But in actuality, the prodigal son thought that he will be punished, but he didn't realize that his repentance will draw God's mercy. My friends, let us always remind ourselves that throughout our life, we will be needing the good shepherd. That throughout our life, we will be like sheep. We will be lost apart from the shepherd. The only way that there will be provision, that there will be protection for the sheep, is when the good shepherd is there, when the presence of the good shepherd is there. That will make a sheep complete. In our case, our life will be full in abundance whenever we are with God, the good shepherd. So let us call the good shepherd in this song, and let us ask him to forgive our sins.
We like sheep have gone astray, each of us turning our own separate ways. We all have sinned and fallen short of your glory. But your glory is what we desire to see. And in your presence is where we long to be. Oh Lord, show us your mercy and grace. Take us to your holy place. Forgive us, please. taking of sickness, taking of pain. Jesus, the sacrifice lamb, has been slain. He was despised, rejected by men. He took our sin. Draw us near to your Father, through Jesus, your Son. Let us worship before you, cleansed by your blood. Show us your mercy and grace. Take us to your holy place. Forgive our sins and heal our land. We long to live in your presence once again. Show us your mercy. Our holy place, forgive our sins, and heal our land. We long to be in your presence once again.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise Hallelujah, you. Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Brothers and sisters, COVID-19 crisis have shaken the world. Most of us went through difficult moments, especially during the peak of this pandemic. But we thank and praise the Lord for what St. Paul has written in Romans chapter 8, verse 28. It says, all things work for the good of those who love God. What a wonderful message of assurance that when we are connected with God and we begin to love Him, all things will work for your good. How can things go wrong if you're connected with God? No matter how bad the situation is, being connected with God, He can make good out of it. Surely, most of us have certain experiences like that in our life. We call it blessing in disguise. So let us give thanks of what God has done for us and what He is going to do.
Through all the faith, we know your grace.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. We praise and glorify you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for all the blessings. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord
Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you for the life you've given to us, Lord. Thank you for all the blessings. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for the job. Thank you for the family, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We praise you and glorify your holy name, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Brothers and sisters, indeed, God is so good to us. God is so gracious to all of us. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart has imagined what God has prepared for those who love him. My friends, there is only one thing God is asking from you and me. And what is that? It is to fall in love with God, to love him. Because falling in love with God will complete the circuit of love into that fullness of life. But for us to fall in love with God, we need the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit must anoint us. So what we need to do now is to call the Holy Spirit. In Ephesians chapter 4, verse 30, St. Paul reminds us that there are times we drive away the Holy Spirit. Sometimes we are not aware of this. My friends, let us remind ourselves that the Holy Spirit cannot take control unless we yield. He cannot take control unless we surrender. His gifts and power are not available unless we ask him to anoint us. And tonight, that's what we are going to ask God for, to anoint us. Anoint can mean healing. Anoint is empowered. So let us call the Holy Spirit to fall upon us and anoint us.
Holy Spirit, fall on me now. I need your anointing, coming upon. I love you, Holy Spirit. You're captivating my soul. In every day, I grow to love you more. Come, Holy Spirit, fall on me now. I need your anointing, come in your power. I love you, Holy Spirit. You're captivating my soul, and every day I grow to love you more. I'm reaching for your hand, you hold my life in your hands, drawing me closer to you. I feel your power in you, nothing compares to this place where I can see your face to face. I worship you in spirit and in truth. I'm reaching for your heart. You hold my life in your hands, drawing me closer to you. I feel your power in you. Nothing compares to this place where I can see you face to face. I worship you in spirit and in truth. I worship you in spirit and in truth. I worship you in spirit and in truth.
Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We praise you.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Lord Jesus.
Brothers and sisters, one of the things that we can do, we may say, blessed to be with, is praise and worship. We take worship seriously because we know that worship is holiness. It is not just singing, not just kneeling, not just tongues or raising our hands. Worship is a desire for holiness, pursuing the holiness of God. And that's the reason we praise, and that's the reason we worship. And that's what we were created for. I mean, when God opens our eyes, because he wants us to look at him. And when we look at him, his holiness will manifest in our lives because we can see him. And when we look at him and seeing him, we begin to imitate him. That's why we gaze at his loveliness. Surely all of us here have known the reason why we live.
Yes, Jesus.
There is only one reason why God opens our eyes in the morning. Because of one reason.
We worship you, Lord Jesus.
To worship you.
We worship your holiness, Lord Jesus.
When I look into your holiness.
Yes, Lord.
When I gaze into your love. When all things that surround become shadows in the light of you.
Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
When I found the joy of preaching your heart. When my will becomes enthralling my life. When all things that surround become shadows in the light of you.
We worship you, Lord.
I worship you.
We worship you, Lord Jesus.
I worship you, Lord.
We glorify your name, O Lord Jesus.
The reason I
live. We worship you.
Is to worship you.
Yes, Lord.
I worship you. I worship you. The reason I live is to worship
you. We love you, Lord.
The reason I live,
is to worship you. Hallelujah, Lord.
We worship you, Lord Jesus. We glorify your name, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We praise you, Lord God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, we praise you, glorify your name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We love you, Lord.
You are the Lord.
We love you, Lord Jesus. Lord. We love you, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We praise and glorify you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus.
Brothers and sisters, if you remember in John chapter 4, Jesus was talking to a Samaritan woman, one-on-one, face-to-face, in Jacob's well, talking about water. And then the woman asked Jesus, Master, where shall we worship? The Jews worship in the temple, and we Samaritans worship in the mountain. Where shall we worship? And then the Lord said, you should worship in the Spirit. My friends, let's keep our heart temple of the Spirit. And then we can worship in this temple from your heart with love and praise. Yes, so brothers and sisters, with all our hearts, with all our minds, and with all our strength, let us worship the Lord in the splendor of his
brother
holiness.
Sister, let's
for he
the
is
Lord.
The Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We
name.
Want to worship you, Almighty God, for there is none like you.
We worship you,
Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Praise you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord.
We worship you.
Worship you.
Almighty God.
Almighty God.
There is none like you.
There is none like you.
We worship you, Lord.
I worship you.
O Prince of Peace.
Of peace.
Yes, Lord.
That is what I want to do.
We give you praise, Lord Jesus.
You praise, for you are my righteousness.
Yes, we worship you, Lord.
We worship you, Lord Jesus.
We worship you,
Almighty God.
Almighty God.
There is none like you. There is no other than you. You are the King. You are the Lord. You are the Almighty. Yes, Lord. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We praise you. We glorify
you. O Prince of Peace. What I
worship
want
you, Lord Jesus.
To
worship
do,
you, Lord Jesus.
And I give you praise.
We worship you, Lord Jesus.
For you are my right.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. Worship you.
Hallelujah.
Almighty
Hallelujah,
God.
Hallelujah.
There is none like you.
Hallelujah.
I worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you.
There is none like you, Lord. You are the only one. You are the only one. You are the best one. You are the awesome God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord Jesus. Lord,
In the silence of our hearts and minds, speak to us, Lord, for your servants are listening. Yes, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord Jesus.
Praise
you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord God. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord God.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise you, Lord God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the wonderful time you have given to us to worship you in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
Thank you, brothers and sisters. And that concludes our praise and worship.
Thank you so much.
So now, let us prepare ourselves to listen and meditate on the Word of God. Tonight, we are so fortunate to have Brother Joy Anthony, who will share with us the Word of God. He was a former prayer group leader, a former Mysore Diocesan coordinator for 2 terms, he was also a former chairman of Karnataka State Service Team, an NST member from 2010 to 2013, and from 2016 to 2019. He's also the NST coordinator for the term 2019 to 2022. Currently, he is the principal of Theresian High School in Mysore. God blessed him and his wife with 2 children. So brothers and sisters, let us all welcome with the love of the Lord, Brother Joy Anthony.
Thank you, beloved brother, for welcoming, for the warm welcome. Now, before we start this session, I request you to stretch your hands toward the screen and please pray for me so that when I speak, as the Peter was speaking, everyone was filled with Holy Spirit. Let the same anointing happen right now. Let us all pray in tongues. Here alalaya and here alalaya. Here alalaya and here alalaya. Here alalaya. Here alalaya. Here alalaya. Here alalaya. Here alalaya. Here
alalaya. Thank you, Lord. Praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Praise.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Dear friends, I'm just going to share my testimony. Along with my testimony, I'm just going to share that how I was strengthened by Lord as I was selected as the national service team coordinator for CCR in India, you know, the coordinator before, prior to me was Brother Cyril John. He's a very, a great personality, a great coordinator. You know, he's a CARIS member also. And when I took over the coordinatorship from the great person, you can understand, I am such a timid person I was. I used to be always reluctant. I never used to stand in front of people. So even people started speaking. Now CCR in India will be in a different phase. I was really worried. Lord, why you have chosen me? Then I started praying. Lord, you strengthen me. Such a great responsibility you have given me. I know I am not fit for that post. I know I am not able, but I know you have seen something in me, and because of that, you have selected me. I just was praying. I was selected in the month of June 2019. So 2019 June till January 2020, things went on okay, because all the programs were planned in the previous team also. So things were going on very well. I was really worried, what next, how we'll proceed. And that was the time, you know, the pandemic came into. Really speaking, I was little happy one way, because now, because of the pandemic reason, I started praying, Lord, you strengthen me. And I have seen Lord started strengthening me, and great initiatives started happening in our country, even in the midst of pandemic. I'm just going to tell you how I could become little more strong than in the past. So when I share this testimony, Lord inspired me one day to read Matthew chapter 16, 13 onwards. Matthew chapter 16, 13 onwards. As Jesus and disciples reached Caesarea Philippi, then Jesus asked a question, an evaluation he was doing. What do people say that I am? Then, you know, they were saying, some are saying that you are John the Baptist. Some are saying that you are Jeremiah. And some say that you are one of the prophets. And different answers the disciples were giving. Actually, this passage in a liturgical year, at least 4 to 5 times we used to hear during the Holy Mass. And suddenly, in the 15th word, Matthew chapter 16, 15th word, Jesus is asking to Simon, what do you say about me? Can you, if anyone can read that passage, Matthew chapter 16, 15. Matthew chapter 15, 16 says, he said to them, but who do you say that I am? But who do you say that I am? And we know, Peter said,
Simon Peter answered, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered him, blessed are you, Simon, the son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven.
Thank you, brother. Praise the Lord. Dear friends, here I'm just focusing on 2 points. Jesus is asking Peter, who do you say that I am? And Peter said, you are the Son of the living God. Then what was the reply of Jesus? That 18th word, if you read, Jesus says, I say to you that you are Peter. Until that time, what was his name? His name was Simon. Simon is not having a high weightage name. Simon is something like a dry grass. The name, the actual dictionary meaning is something like a dry grass. It is not having high weightage. The parents or the people of Simon might have put this name as Simon. But now Jesus is telling that you are Peter. We know Isaiah chapter 49, 1 says, before you were born in the mother's womb, I have called you by name. That means before we were born, God has given us a name. God had great plans about us. What we should become and how we should move about. God has got great plan. Now, this plan was fulfilled only when Peter understood who Jesus is. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Until that time, people were saying, he's only Simon. Simon is not having any weightage. But when Peter understood who Jesus is, Jesus revealed who Peter is. Dear brothers and sisters, this is a great good news that if you are able to understand who Jesus is, Jesus is going to reveal who you are. Now, when we just continue this passage, we understand that Jesus is not only telling about his name, he is revealing his plan about Peter. There are four plans we are seeing here. I will build the church on you. It was planned before Peter was born. Before Peter was born, God planned that the church will be built on Peter. Then it was revealed when Peter understood who Jesus is. And not only that, Jesus is telling, I'll give the keys of heaven to you. Again, this also was planned before he was born in the mother's womb. So let us try to understand. So God has got great plan about each one of us. He had planned great thing about us. Now, when this plan will be revealed, when we understand Jesus in its fullness, what percentage we are understanding, that percentage the plan about us will be revealed. Now, when Peter understood Jesus in his fullness, Jesus revealed Peter in his fullness. So sometimes we may be thinking, I'm fit for nothing. I'm not able to do these things. I'm not able to coordinate this. I'm not able to preach. I'm not able to lead the praise and worship. But truly, I'll tell you, when we understand who Jesus is, Jesus is going to reveal who you are. People may see us, we are fit for nothing. People may think that we are not up to the mark. But truly, I'll tell you, when we understand who Jesus is in his fullness, Jesus is going to reveal who we are. I can demonstrate it. I can prove it. Today during the praise and worship, brother said about Samaritan woman. Now I am asking you, is Samaritan woman was a bad lady or a good lady? I think I want you to respond. It can be an interactive session. Like, is Samaritan woman was a bad lady or a good lady?
Good lady. What is your...
Bad lady.
Okay. People say that she is a bad lady. But I'll tell you, if she was a bad lady, what made her to stop going for drawing water in the morning and the evening? What was the reason? If she was a bad lady, it would have been good going in the morning and evening when people are there. Correct, no? Why she had to go through during this? Why she had to go during the noon where it is very hot? You know the temperature of desert during the noon time. Even I was there for 2 times in Kuwait. I know at noon time what will be the temperature. So what was the reason? Now, if she was a bad lady, surely should have been gone in the morning where people are there, or evening when people are there. Now, her problem is she was really wounded in her heart. She was finding very difficult to face the people. She had a lot of hurt feeling. So whenever people look at her, people see in a very negative way, which hurt her. And she thought, it is better to be, suffer the temperature of the noon than hearing hearing negative things about me from the people. So she went in the noon. I'm just getting into this point. We have heard this Samaritan woman many times, maybe. I'm sure Lord is going to speak to you in a different way. Now let us visualize that scene. Samaritan woman went to the well site and she is drawing the water. Who is sitting nearby? Jesus. Now, Jesus is asking her. Now consider when Jesus asked her, give me a drink. What would have been this lady's response? You tell me, if she was a bad lady, it would be a good chance for making an interaction, no? But she was very furious when Jesus asked for a drink. What she said? What this Samaritan woman told Jesus when he asked for a drink? She said, you are a Jew. Yeah. John chapter 4, it comes. John chapter 4, verses 8. 7 and 8, it comes there. Please read John chapter 4, verses 9. Let us read that. John chapter 4, verses 9.
The Samaritan woman said to him, how is it that you, a Jew, ask a drink of me? A woman of Samaria.
According to Samaritan woman, Jesus is just a Jew. So she was very furious. If you see the movie of the Samaritan woman, we see very furious way she is looking at Jesus. You are a Jew. I am a Samaritan. Now, after that, Jesus started speaking. Jesus answered and said, if you knew the gift of God and who is saying to you to give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water. Mm-hmm. When Jesus started speaking to her, whatever Jesus speaks, it is the word of God. When the Samaritan woman heard the word of God, what happened? It penetrated into her heart. And word of God heals the people. When Jesus spoke, whatever the words came from Jesus, when the Samaritan woman heard, actual healing process started there. And that is the reason why, when you read further, after hearing from Jesus, in the 12th word we are seeing, from the 11th word, can you please read 11th word?
The woman said to him, sir, you have no bucket and the well is deep. Where do you get the living water? Are you greater than our...
She said, you are a Jew. According to the Samaritan woman, you are a Jew. But when she heard what Jesus is speaking, and when she heard the word of God, it started healing her, and she is now according to her. Now see, the way she approached her differ. She said, sir, no, before you are a Jew, now this Samaritan woman is saying, sir, you don't have bucket with you, then how can you give the water? And later in the 12th word, we know she's telling, are you greater than our forefather Jacob? Now, after hearing little word of God, the word of God healed, started healing, penetrate into her heart. He started healing her inner wound. And she became little opened up. And she started asking, sir, are you greater than our forefather Jacob? According to Samaritan woman, now Jesus is greater than the forefather. See, as she understands Jesus, the same degree she is getting healed. She is getting healed. Again, Jesus started speaking to her about the living water. And after hearing again, after hearing, she was asking Jesus, give me the water. See, initially she was very furious to answer to Jesus. But now, as she is hearing the word of God, degree by degree, she started getting healed degree by degree. Now, Jesus is asking that you have 5 husbands. And she agreed. Now consider, before if someone else would have been asked the same question, she would have become very angry. She would have been broken up with that. But now, what was the response of this Samaritan woman? She's saying, I know you are a prophet. See, the transformation which is happening in Samaritan woman, if you understand how much she understands Jesus, accordingly, with the same phase, with the same degree, the transformation is happening in Samaritan woman. Again, Jesus started speaking. Jesus is speaking about the worship, high theology Jesus is speaking. That is what during the praise and worship they said. The place of worship. And we just imagine a Samaritan woman who never learned about this scripture, but now Jesus is speaking very high theology about worship, the spirit, and such things. But she understood everything. At the end, she is saying that, I know that Messiah will come. I know that Messiah will come. Dear friends, as the Samaritan woman is hearing the word of God, she could understand who Jesus is. And after, at the end of the conversation, she herself said, you are Jesus. She discovered who Jesus is. When a person discovers who Jesus is, what transformation is going to happen? What did she do? After understanding who Jesus is, what did she do? She went to her town. Now imagine, she was finding very difficult to come in the morning as well as evening to draw the water, because people will speak ill of her. People will think negative about her, and that is the reason why she was not ready to go in the morning and evening for drawing water. Now, what made her to go to the same people and saying that, I have seen Jesus? Can you tell what may be the reason? Anyone? Now, just try to understand. The morning she was not going because she was frightened of going. People will say ill of her. Evening also the same thing. But now she has gone to the same village and she has faced the same people and she said, I have met Jesus. You all come and meet him. Can you tell me what may be the reason? What made her to go to face the people very powerfully? Anyone? What may be the reason? Because she was finding very difficult to go in the morning to draw water, evening to draw water. Because she was frightened, people may say very ill of her. Now, the same lady, now very straightforward way, she is going to a village. Same village. And she is speaking to same people that I have seen Jesus. The reason is, during this conversation, when Jesus started speaking And whatever Jesus speaking is the word of God. Word of God heals. And she was healed completely. Now her inner wounds were completely healed. She became free. When she understood who Jesus is, Jesus started revealing her who she is. And Jesus revealed her in such a way that you have to become an evangelizer. So she understood, my role is not drawing water and doing all this business. I have to become an evangelizer. When she understood who Jesus is, Jesus revealed her who she is. And she went to her own village. And normally, when she comes, what would have been the response of the people? Oh, this is a sixth person or seventh person. Like that, the people would have been asked, but people did not ask her. People simply followed her. Imagine, she had a commanding power to draw the whole people towards Jesus. Normally, these people would not have gone to the desert to draw water in the noontime. But just by hearing the word of Samaritan woman, they all started followed her. And during the noontime only, maybe 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock, very hot time, they all followed. Samaritan woman is leading. The whole city, whole village is following her during this hot sun. I mean, the afternoon time, they all went to Jesus. The real reason, if you try to analyze, when she understood who Jesus is, Jesus revealed her who she is. And with that, her inner wounds were healed. She went to the town, she went to the village. She boldly started proclaiming the word of God. And remember, all the people accepted her. She became an evangelist. And now, if you check the internet, Google, if you check, you will see that. If you just type Samaritan woman, you will find that her name is Saint 49. Her name is Saint 49. See, before she was born in the mother's womb, God called her Saint 49. But people around her called her, she is a wrong lady, she is a prostitute, and different way people started calling her. But when she discovered who Jesus is in his fullness, Jesus completely healed her. And whatever call God has given before she was born, and that call she received, and she became an evangelist. Finally, she became a great saint, 49. Photon means light, 49. So she, the actual name of Samaritan woman is Saint 49. And she had 3 children, and these 3 children also became martyrs, and these 3 children also became the saints. So dear friends, as we are concluding, that our time is getting over, as we are concluding this session, when Peter understood who Jesus is, Jesus revealed who Peter is. Right from name, and the call, and the plan about Peter was completely revealed when Peter understood who Jesus is. Even the same question is asking to us. Lord is asking the same question to us. What do you say that I am? If you tell me who am I will tell you who are you. Jesus is telling the same point to us. If we tell who Jesus is, Jesus is going to reveal who we are. We are supposed, we may be thinking we are not able to do all these things. But I'll tell you, we are called to be great saints only when we understand who Jesus is in his fullness. What percentage we understand, and the same level we will be also revealed. I started with how I managed to become, how I managed to coordinate the CARIS National Service of Communion in India. As I constantly, morning, the night and day, I started asking, Lord, reveal me who you are. Lord, reveal me who you are. Constantly I started praying, And degree by degree, Lord showed me who Jesus is. And with that, little by little, degree by degree, Lord reveal me about my call and what I am supposed to do. And dear friends, I plead you that let us have this desire in our heart. I need to know who Jesus is in his fullness. Maybe we may be thinking, we know Jesus is God. We know Jesus is a healer. We know Jesus is, he can heal us. So many things we know about Jesus. But what is our experience about Jesus? We have to, just like Samaritan woman, we have to converse with him. We have to constantly ask him, Lord, reveal me who you are. Reveal me who you are. As he is revealing not only who he is, he will reveal who we are also. So God has got a great plan about each one of us. He has planned everything about us before we were born in the mother's womb. Only thing is we need to discover who Jesus is. So I pray that may God bless each one of us to discover who Jesus is. And sometime, see, just like God has given, Jesus has given the keys of heaven, we also may give, there are so many apartments, it seems, in the heaven. We also may get the keys of certain apartments so that we can also take our people to the heaven also. So may God bless each one of us to discover Jesus in his fullness. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, Brother Joy Anthony, for sharing with us the word of God. Now, may I call on Sister Catherine to lead us in the intercessory prayer.
Brother, thank you for your this evening. You shared the word of God with us. We are all very much thankful to you. We know that it is a very late time in India, around 10:30, but You put your all the efforts and time for us. We are very grateful to you and thank you. And on behalf of everyone, those who gathered here, and for CARES Kuwait and National Service Communion, we thank you very much. And we'll all pray for you, for your good leadership for the Indian National Service team. Thank you very much, brother. And we will have
you,
another...
Another
30 minutes, we will have the intercession. You are also welcome to be with us. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Brother Abhi and Angela, for inviting me. Thank you. God bless.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. As we start with our intercessory prayer, in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. I'm requesting each and everyone to open our hearts and minds and lift everything to God. Almighty and our loving God, we thank and praise you today. You are God who can do all things. Your abundance, love, and mercy are unending. You reign above all power and might in your hands. Sanctify our hearts that we may be worthy of your graces and love. Cleanse our mind, heart, and spirit. Free us from worries that we may lift our prayers to you with a clean heart. We thank you, Father, for all the graces we receive through your kindness and mercy. O God, our Creator, we glorify you. O Lord Jesus, living in us, we adore you. O Holy Spirit, our helper and our counselor, we praise and thank you. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, our divine master, you have said, truly I say to you, ask and you will receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. Behold, I knock, I seek, and I ask for all our needs. We come before your throne seeking for your mercy. And with the intercession of our mother and your mother, we beg for your graces and mercy. This we pray. Amen. prayer for the health of all people all over the world. We are all at risk due to the pandemic of COVID-19 virus. Hit hard and in shock, all nations find every means to stop the massive death of people. With courage, faith, and dedication to serve, healthcare providers bravely face the challenge until the virus is treated and controlled. In Psalm 33, verse 13 to 14 says, "The Lord looks down from heaven. He sees all mankind. From where he sits enthroned, he watches all the inhabitants of the earth." Let us pray. Lord Jesus, please continue to send down your wisdom, courage, and perseverance to all healthcare providers. Bless their tired bodies and weary mind due to the long, weary hours of work and prolonged agony in the fight to stop the virus. May they find solace and comfort, believing that they are united with you in caring for mankind. We pray for our specialists, scientists, researchers, as they continue their study to produce what can restore people's health. We pray for healthcare support system to be available, especially to the marginalized countries, that help may reach in terms of the vaccine. Extend your healing hands to those who have, to those who are suffering with illness and those who are suffering from COVID-19, that they may see another day in their lives. Lord, we pray for those who need medical treatment but forced to wait due to the pandemic. Grant healing to the sick, eternal life to the dead, and consolation to the bereaved families. Look upon us, your mercy, and hear our humble prayers. Be all honor, praise, and thanksgiving unto you, Father, with Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, in the intercession of our Mother. Amen. For all families all over the world. There are so many homes and families suffering from non-harmonious relationships, broken families, conflict between parents and children, infidelities of couples, conflicts between in-laws, single parenthood, abandonment of children and elders, domestic violence, out-of-school youth due to poverty, financial problems due to loss of jobs, loss of parent provider. Let us bear in mind that marriage is a sacrament instituted by Christ and that He is the author of our lives. In Psalm chapter 133, verse 1, "Look at how good and pleasing it is when families live together as one." Let us pray. Lord Jesus, help of the helpless, you come to lift humanity from the snare of sins. Many homes and families are sinking in misery and sin. Please come to their aid. Let us, parents, they may be the source of strength and encouragement of their children. Lord God, give them the widest understanding and wisdom when children become difficult to handle. May they become as strong and compassionate as parents. We offer to you, O Lord, our youth of today, that they may not succumb in the depression because of what has been seen in social media. They may know the truth and seek help. Send your angels to guide them so that they may find happiness in their home with their own families. Remind them, Lord, of your commandment to honor their parents. May they find true friends who will lead them to you and to your kingdom. We offer prayers for families who lost a family member in any way. Maybe they be consoled by your grace, knowing that their loved ones are already with you in paradise. Father, we pray for more generous people to open their doors to suffering families. All this we pray to the name of your Son, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, with intercession of Mama Mary. Lord God, hear and answer our plea. Amen. Encourage each and everyone to uplift their prayers to our Mother. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
For our closing remarks, may I call on Brother Abby. Okay, maybe we can request Father Noel for the closing prayer and for the final blessings.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pause for a while and feel the presence of God. And as the Lord has spoken to us, and as we heard the reflection, let us become aware of who God is and also become aware of who we are. We are at the mercy of God. Let us prepare ourselves to seek His blessings. The Lord be with you. God, our Heavenly Father, bless each and every member who participated in this prayers service, praise and worship, and for the beautiful reflection through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, through John. And we ask your blessings upon each and every one, our family members and all the members of KNSC. Keep us, each and every one of us, under your care and protection. Let your face shine upon us and be gracious to us. Look upon us with your kindness.
Hallelujah.
And grant us your peace and joy, grace and salvation, mercy and forgiveness, health and healing. Grant success in all our undertakings. Help us to do your will, and may your will be done in us, in our families, as it is in heaven. Bless all of us, O Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you all. Sorry, my mic was not working for a while. Thank you all. This day was very, very wonderful. God guide us, our mighty hands, and thanks to our God. And I'm also thankful to Father Noel, our spiritual director, for his presence and the final prayer and blessing. And FCCK, I know that I thank FCCK, all members, core team, and the choir team who lead the praise and worship. We know that you have taken so much pain now to get this day very, very successful and wonderful. We had a great praise and worship and the leading of prayer. We thank you all for your kind efforts for this day. And also I thank Brother Alistair for all the technical support for today. And again, I thank everyone who attended here this prayer meeting on behalf of Karis Kuwait and National Service Communion. I thank everyone. Our next monthly gathering, next November monthly gathering, is on November 10th. In that meeting, the Word of God will be shared by Sister Michelle Moran. I believe everyone knows Sister Michelle Moran. She was a former president of ICRIS, ICCRS. So I welcome in advance everyone to attend that prayer meeting next November 10th of Wednesday, second Wednesday. And now, okay, let us conclude our closing hymn with the FCCK. Thank you.
Good night, everyone. Thank you. Good night.
God bless. Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you. Praise the Lord.
Picture.
Thank you to God.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you.
Allow me.